Fox News alert for you now, because we're getting reports of what could be another bloodbath in Syria. This is brand new video. Look at that scene of chaos. We are told that that is government forces firing tear gas in the capital city of Damascus. But we are also hearing that thousands of villagers from the surrounding area walked up to the city limits in support, and that Syrian soldiers opened fire on them. Reena Ninan is live in Jerusalem. Reena.
Ali, for the first time, we are really seeing these increased protests taking place in the capital of Damascus. That's something we haven't really seen in the past. These taking place in what's known as Souk al-Hamidiyah. It's usually a tourist site. Obviously, these days, tourists aren't really flocking to Syria. But the site of large protests today, that's not the only location in Syria today. Various parts of the country experiencing protests. Demonstrators were calling today again another day of rage. And as you mentioned, we are hearing that Syrian forces fired on villagers, also in the town of Dera, during demonstrations today. More than 120 people have been killed this week alone, 500 according to one human rights group, since all of these protests began 6 weeks ago. We have been watching Syrian state TV over the past few days, and they have been releasing what they call our confessions from protesters that they have arrested and detained, saying that these men claim they were given weapons and orders from their local Muslim clerics in the mosques, telling them to fire on and kill Syrian army soldiers, and also to set fire onto President Assad's ruling Ba'ath Party headquarters. That is something that the opposition is denying and saying is a fabricated claim. When we monitor their Facebook pages, they are denouncing these claims on Syrian state TV. Also reports that the Syrian army is taking up more tanks and more troops rolling into Damascus. That is interesting and very key. And also that these demonstrations are continuing, in fact, Ali, as I speak. And the death toll, unfortunately, analysts say, is only expected to rise in that country. Ali.
Oh, how ominous. Reena Ninan, thanks so much for the update.